So if you're running FreeNAS in VirtualBox, you may encounter a issue where the page only loads partially. So you can see I'm missing my menus along the top, the side menus. What's happening is there's an incompatibility between the web server's sendfile, and which is a feature of the web server, and FreeNAS. VirtualBox. So if you're using VirtualBox with a web server that's using sendfile, files like CSS files and JavaScript files will get corrupted, and so the page will not load completely or it won't look right. Sometimes the page will load completely, but it'll perform really slowly and it won't look right because some of the CSS files are corrupted, but you may still be able to work with the web page. So it seems to be kind of intermittent that you get this issue. But the way to fix it is to actually go and edit the config file of the web server and turn off the sendfile feature. And then it works fine. So 9 to go to the shell in FreeNAS. So we're going to go up a level. And then we're going into user. Local etc, and then there's a folder for the web server, which is nginx. That's the web server they're using. And you see there's two config files here. There's an nginx.conf and an nginx.conf-dist. I don't know if that's distribution or what that stands for. I found I had to edit both of them. I tried just this one and that wasn't enough. So I edited both. Maybe you only have to edit this one. I'm not sure, but I don't want to spend a lot of time rebooting and testing, so we're just going to go down here using Easy Edit and change this to off, and then you hit Escape and it'll pop up a menu. Enter to leave the editor, and then it'll ask you if you want to save changes. Enter again and changes are saved. I'm going to hit the up arrow key to go to my previous command and then add the -dist for the other file. So you can see the command is EE for easy edit and then space the file name and then enter and arrow down down to sendfile. And then escape, enter, leave editor, enter, save changes. Now we need to restart the nginx service. So we're going to use a service command telling it the service we want to restart is nginx and telling it the command we want to do is restart. Enter. And that happens really fast, stopping nginx and then starting nginx. So this loads the configuration file again and takes effect. So let's go back to our web browser and right control to break out of the VirtualBox window. And this is the IP address of my local server. I'm going to control F5. All right. So the reason you have to hold control and then F5 is because when you just F5 or refresh, it uses the cached CSS and JavaScript files. Those files were corrupt. So we need to control F5 to force it to say, hey, I need to get new files from the web server. And now it's fixed. Yay. All right. And that's pretty much that I forgot to mention is this will not stick if you restart the VirtualBox machine. What happens is the config files are refreshed and you get new config files. Oh, also to break out of this shell menu, type exit, enter. And if you reboot or shut down and reboot or shut down from VirtualBox, you're gonna lose those changes and you're gonna have the issue again. You're gonna have to go through that process. So if you can avoid rebooting the web server, what you can do is you can do a pause. And what this will do is rather than shut down the server, it'll actually save it as if it were, as if your computer were going to hibernate. It saves all the RAM. So we can close it out and use this option to save machine state. And this is going to look at all the RAM and save it. It uses some extra hard drive space to do that, because it has to say however much RAM you're giving this thing or however much it happens to be using. It may not, you know, I gave this 4 gigabytes, but it might not be using a full 4 gigabytes. Nevertheless, now I can come back and start it and it's going to go right back to where it was before. So you don't lose your changes to your config files. The reason FreeNAS works like this by clearing out those config changes is that you should be using the FreeNAS GUI to back up your configuration. I forget where exactly that is at. System, I believe it's under settings. So you can save your config file and upload it later. So the idea is that if you're backing up your config and you have good redundancy on all your pools, then if your root drive crashes or something goes wrong with the operating system, you can just reinstall FreeNAS, upload your last config file, and possibly do import volumes or auto import volumes and basically reconnect your pools as they were, and you're good to go. It'd be nice if the save config actually included like the website config and things like that. Maybe they'll add that in the future so that you can make customizations as needed. So just wanted to point that out. All right, that's all.